introduce the band and these wonderful singers that we have here tonight. Elizabeth Merrill. Catherine Hedberg. Aiden Pedrati. Amber Evans. Behind me is Gary Wong on bass. Noel Brennan is in the corner on drums. Patricia Brennan on vibes. Sarah Schoenbeck on bassoon. Mike McGinnis on clarinet. Maine is in the house. I'm Dana Lynn. So, some of you know that I talk a lot on stage because I get nervous and it's like a tick and I have to work it. I have to work it out. And I usually also wear orange pants, but I didn't wear them tonight because I thought it's Joe's Pub. I don't think it's going to go right with the lights. So I didn't wear my orange pants. So I'm extra nervous now. And I found this shirt 15 years ago in a thrift store in San Francisco. And I thought, this is what I'm going to wear when I form my disco orchestra. But I didn't form it, ever. So this is the only time I've ever worn it. Anyway, preamble. So this is an album release concert. He remembered. I didn't remember. So it took me, I guess, something like 8 years to write all this music. I need to give you this story because it's such a good story, and maybe it'll help this experience go by in a deeper way. But basically, there is a woman named Jay DeFeo. Her dates are 1929 to 89. She was a visual artist that was based in the San Francisco Bay Area. And from the time that she was 28 to about 35, she worked on one painting and one painting alone, which is, sounds maybe slightly obsessive. She didn't work on anything else except this one painting. And she had it placed in her bay window on 2322 Fillmore Street for anyone representing the bay here. And it grew, literally, to 13 by 8 and 1 foot thick with paint. So just think about like a foot thick of paint and what that might look and feel like. I'll also say that she shoplifted something like $5,355 worth of paint to make this thing. And the other good fact about this, especially if you're from the Bay Area, is that her rent was only $65 a month. So, yeah, just given that, I love the story so much because it makes no sense at all to what we know about San Francisco today or rent. So anyway, because she was caught shoplifting, she couldn't teach anymore. And she worked on this thing like it was her salvation, And then she got evicted because even $65 was too much. And there's a beautiful short film that commemorates this that you should try to go see by Bruce Conner that actually shows the painting being removed. Like six men from this moving company had to figure this out. And they had to chop away part of the wall and airlift it out her third floor apartment. It's kind of incredible. And then it went into the basement of another art museum and then she kept working on it. And apparently, she was using all these toxic chemicals. She smoked way more than she should have. Maybe she drank a couple of bottles of brandy every day. I don't know. But anyway, after this experience, her teeth all fell out. And then she didn't paint for 4 years. And then the painting was transferred into another basement and entombed, literally. And no one saw it for 25 years until the Whitney came along and bought it. By this point, she was already dead. So that's the sad part of the story. I don't know, is there a happy part? Have you found the happy part yourself? I guess the capitalist part is that the Whitney bought it. The Whitney bought it. So you can go see it at the Whitney right now. I mean, tomorrow afternoon, morning. I'll go with you. So anyway, I made this piece about this painting. And I'm not going to talk too much after this. Just a couple of things. We're going to start now. Okay. This is the first movement. This next part is called Dingbats. Actually, I have nothing much to say about this except that it features Sarah Schoenbeck. The middle section that is going to feature these amazing singers, feel like you're in a cult. My direction to them was pretend like you're drunk and in a cult. But this is basically about this tune to me is about San Francisco. It's a dance tune if anyone wants to get out of their seats.
Thank you. that the world is smaller than it used to be. Having a drink. Thank you.
Thanks, everyone. This next song is called Daytime Atheist, and it's featuring these lovely musicians.
but still cannot find a way in or out of extreme.
Back to the painting, right? I don't know really what I mean, you kind of need to go see it for yourself. It's called The Rose. And for the first 2 years, she called it The Death Rose. Sounds pretty, that's what, you know, what else is there? And the next 3 years or so was called The White Rose, and then the next 4 years or so was just The Rose. So we're gonna play these three pieces. You could probably guess the titles of them. I might not talk in between because I feel like I'm losing the flow when I do that. So I don't know if there's anything I need to describe, except I do want you to just think about what it means to have a painting that is so pregnant with paint, and what that was for her as a canvas, and how it wasn't really a painting at all, it was more like a sculpture. So anyway, I tried, like, people have asked me, like, did you just make this up, or what do you think, like, you this is inspired by paint, like, how are you supposed to, well, no one can prove me wrong anyway, because, so that's my answer. But there are kind of rhythmic things, there's some patterns, if you find it, well, you know, now we have the internet, so you actually don't have to go to the Whitney, but let me tell you, it's really not the same. I know there's people who might be live streaming from California or Canada. You know, it's not the same as being here, folks. Anyway, it's the same thing. It's like looking at it on your phone, it's not going to be the same as being in a room with a one-ton painting. So I urge you to go do it. But anyway, I'm not going to keep talking. Okay. We're just going to play some music for you now. So, called Death Rose, White Rose, and The Rose.
Troubled marriage of words and
That's pretty stressful for us to play, so. Might have even been stressful for you to listen to. I think that's like if you work on something for 8 years, I think you'd be kind of stressed about it. I also realized that, you know, I wrote all these lyrics and that's not really something I do, and I just kind of made them all about music and writing because I'm not a painter and I know nothing about that, and, you know, so if you were wondering, that's why. Anyway, we're gonna do this now. Thanks for listening. Thanks for being here.
Oh.
So this last one is called The Removal, because to me the painting was sort of like a really large body, so that's why I called it The Removal. I know that's really dark, bringing you right down on Tuesday night. So I wanted to introduce everyone again, in the same order, Elizabeth Merrill, Catherine Hedberg, Adrian Pedrotti, all the way from Austin, Texas. Amber Evans. And I also have to say, you know, the times that we live in, you know, you couldn't expect everything to go that smoothly. So Amber actually learned all of this music, put it all into her head last week when someone else tested positive. So thank you very much. Gary Wong on bass behind me. Noel Brennan on drum. Patricia Brennan on vibraphones and effects. Sarah Schoenbeck on bassoon. Mike McGinnis on clarinet. So we'll be out there, or at least I will be out there, because I want to say hi to everybody. I want to get a hug. And there's also some CDs. For those of you with cars that were made, you know, before 2016 or whatever it is. Yeah, there's some drawings. I made some drawings. You can really check out the detail from where you're sitting, I'm sure. There's like a little lyric booklet. It's amazing to me how little this cost compared to when I was making a record maybe 10 years ago, like how much that would cost. This costs very little. See, look, check it out. If anyone was wondering why there was a blue jay there, it's because of Jay DeFeo. Anyway. Oh, yeah, see? Okay. Anyway, we'll be outside. David Driver right over there did all the graphic layout for me. Woohoo! He also, I have to say, because those of you who know me personally know how I'm sort of allergic to the smartphone. And I only got one last year anyway. And I'm really terrible at the self-promotion or the gig alerts and all this stuff. And so a month ago, David said to me, this is what you're going to do 3 weeks before this concert. This is what you're going to send out a week before the concert. This is what you're going to send out 3 days before the concert. And then yesterday I didn't do anything. And I get a note from him saying, you really should try to send something out today. So thank you, David. And also, Johnny Gandelsman is here, and he put this record out on his label In a Circle. So thank you, Johnny. And thank you to John Triver up there doing sound. Yeah. And for the lights, tip your bar staff. Thank you, Joe's Pub, for having me. Alex, if you're here, I don't know if you're here, all of you guys. Thank you so much. And I'm sorry I turned in everything late. Talk to you in a moment. Thank you.